Okay, and then coming to the next one in the 800 series, engagements to report on the summary financial statements. All of you with me? Right, you understand 800, that was special purpose framework. Then 805 was audit of a part of the financial statement. And now we talk about 810, which is summary financial statements. And what did I tell you? For summary financial statements, what you need to remember? It has to be the same uncle. And second, you have to consider the applied criteria, the criteria applied by the management in the preparation of the summary financial statements. Right? The criteria applied by the management. Okay, so these are audited financial statements. From that, management would have prepared the summary financial statements. Auditor has to give an audit report on the summary financial statements. So what he will check, whether this summary is properly prepared based on the audited financial statements, and for a fair presentation framework, he will say, yeah, this summary financial statements is a fair summary of the audited financial statements. Or if it is not a fair summary, he'll say, this is not a fair summary. Okay, in case of fair presentation, and in case of compliance framework, he will say that these summary financial statements are consistent with the audited financial statements. Right? So this is the opinion expressed by the auditor on summary. That these summary, it is a fair summary of the audited financial statements, or this summary, it is consistent with the audited financial statements. It is consistent with the audited financial statements. Right. What was our giant precondition of SA210? Acceptability of AFRF. Can any normally intelligent student in the class guess what would be the giant precondition of SA810? Can any student in the class guess what would be the giant precondition of SA810? Wonderful. It is going to be the acceptability of the applied criteria. Now no AFRF over here. Now it is going to be the acceptability of the applied criteria. Okay, management, the criteria which you are applying for preparing the summary financial statements, is that criteria acceptable to the auditor? So now what they say, we have prepared summary. So what they are saying, we have prepared summary. So this is balance sheet, capital, assets and liability, 2000 crore. 2000 crore, and this is profit and loss, income, expense and provision, profit, and again total. And now they are roaming around. First they were roaming with this 10,000 crore ka debtor. Now they are roaming around everywhere with this summary. And they are saying, see, we have prepared summary. CSC, please give report. Please give report on this summary. CSC says, what is this? CSC, I told you that we are preparing summary. No, this is not summary. This is summary. This is summary raised to 10. This is over summary. You understand? Auditor says, no, I am not accepting this engagement to report on the summary financial statements. Why? Because the applied criteria is not acceptable. So condition number one is the acceptability of the applied criteria. Intelligent students, can you guess condition number two? Acceptability of applied criteria. Yes, I want to check your application skills. Accepting of SA810. What I check? Acceptability of applied criteria. Next one. You say, okay, applied criteria is acceptable. Again. Whose responsibility to prepare the summary financial statements? Uncle? No. It's preparation of summary financial statements in accordance with applied criteria. Whose responsibility? It is management's responsibility. So tell management. And then like we say, preparation, presentation of financial statements in accordance with AFRF. Now here what we say, preparation of summary financial statements in accordance with applied criteria, management, your responsibility. And the expected form and content of the report, the draft format of your opinion. है ना, कि वी विल ईदर से फेयर समरी और इट इज कंसिस्टेंट. दीज आर द थ्री कंसिडरेशंस व्हाइल एक्सेप्टिंग द एंगेजमेंट टू रिपोर्ट ऑन द समरी फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. सो वन तो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, इट हैज टू बी द same auditor. Then after that, what do we say? Condition number one, whether the applied criteria is it acceptable. Once the criteria is acceptable, what is the next condition? Preparation of summary financial statements in accordance with the applied criteria, management your responsibility. And third condition is to agree the form of opinion to be expressed on the summary financial statement. Right, agree on the form of opinion. Right, so now under this acceptance, we have the retail questions over there. Right, we have 3 points under acceptance: acceptability of AC, preparation of summary financial statements as per AC, and the form of opinion to be given. Okay, now acceptability of the applied criteria. I told you what is applied criteria? The criteria applied by the management. So management is responsible for determining the information. Right, and then what does it say? Though it is a part, you know, they are giving summary, but still summary should still have a structured presentation. And what are the considerations while determining the acceptability of the applied criteria? The nature of the entity, the purpose, why they are preparing summary financial statements. So they are saying now to our shareholders, instead of giving complete financial statements, we will give them the summary, whether it will fulfill the needs of the intended users, whether the information needs of the intended users, will they be fulfilled? And when you're giving them the summary financial statements, will it result that the summary financial statements are not misleading in these circumstances? Right, that they are not misleading, when the applied criteria will result in summary financial statements that are not misleading. Right, so acceptability of the applied criteria, for that we have 4 points. One, what is the nature of the entity? Second, purpose, why are they preparing the summary? Then, will summary fulfill the information needs of the users? And will the applied criteria result in summary financial statements which are not misleading? Right? So what we need to do, we need to remember Miss Nupur over here. You know, why Nupur? Because it's N-P-U-R. Or you say, ma'am, to do audit of summary, I'm going to go to Nagpur. Whatever way. And so accept to decide whether I should accept this engagement, I will go to Nagpur, I will take a flight from Mumbai to Nagpur, I will sit at Nagpur at the airport, and then I will think whether I should accept this engagement, is the criteria acceptable. You said, ma'am, you could have done it thinking at your home also. No, I will go to Nagpur and there I will think about it. No, so whether applied criteria is acceptable, what is the nature of the entity, why they are preparing, whether needs of users, information needs will be fulfilled, will it result into information which is not misleading, right? So that is acceptability of the applied criteria. Again, the applied criteria may be given by law or it may be developed by management. Like we said, special purpose framework also, it could be by law or it could be as per the provisions of a contract. So here also applied criteria, it may be given in law or it may be developed by the management. And if you think it is developed by the management and it is unacceptable, then not to accept the engagement. Right? Not to accept the engagement. Right. So that is one, the acceptability of the applied criteria. Then, whose responsibility to prepare summary as per applied criteria? Management's responsibility. So now, yes, what management is going to do from these audited financial statements? They will apply the applied criteria and they will prepare the summary financial statements. So now, users of financial statements, what they are going to receive? Summary. But say I am a user of the financial statement and I say, no, I don't want summary. I want audited. You give me summary, but nahi, I want to see it in detail. So it says to make audited financial statements available without undue difficulty, management your responsibility. All law regulation says that audited financial statements need not be made available. Which law regulation says so? So one, management, you have to prepare summary as per the applied criteria. Second, though you prepared the summary, you have to make the audited available without difficulty. Or there's the law which says that they need not be made available. Then you have to mention which is the law which is said that audited need not be made available. Right? So audited financial statements be made available to the intended users without undue difficulty. Or if law regulation says that they need not be made available. So you have to check whether in the summary financial statements, the management has mentioned from whom or where the audited are available. Then whether the audited are on the public record. And management has a process by which the intended users, right, of the summary can get access to the audited financial statements. Right? So to make audited financial statements available to the users of summary financial statements, whose responsibility? Management's responsibility. It is management's responsibility. Okay, and then agree on the form of the report. Okay, so what are the points that we are talking about over here? Right, the acceptance of the applied criteria, preparation of summary as per applied criteria, and the form of opinion to be reported, the form of opinion to be expressed. Now I come to the $1 million question of SA 810. Everybody, please sit straight. Nature of procedures, SA 810. 800 mein kya bola? Comply with all essays relevant to the audit. 805, what did we say? Adapt all essays which are relevant to the audit. Now can we say comply with essays, adapt all essays? No, no. This is not audit. Title kya hai 810 ka? Engagement to report on summary financial statement. Engagement. It's not audit. It's engagement to report on summary financial statements. Okay, right. So all of you now start, you know, considering you, yourself to be a partner of a Big Four. And which Big Four partner you are becoming? You'll say, no, no, ma'am, I do my own practice. Or whatever. See, you're a partner of a Big Four. And now you have to give an audit report on the summary financial statements. You are the same auditor who's done the audit of the audited financial statements. So now, before you give a report on the summary financial statements, what audit procedures you need to perform? Understanding? Like for forming an opinion, it was an art. Now, here we are discussing the also the procedures for summary financial statements. Point number one. Now for summary financial statements, everybody, are you able to visualize? Okay, aapko report dena hai summary pe. So summary ka report to give, what checking, what procedure you will perform. Point number one. Whether the summary financial statements adequately disclose whether they adequately disclose their summarized nature. And a summarized nature. So, you know, you see the summary financial statements. They've written balance sheet, profit and loss. You say, no, no. Before that, you have to add a prefix. Tell management that you have to write summarized balance sheet, summarized statement of profit and loss, summarized cash flow statement or condensed, whatever you want to do. But adequately disclose their summarized nature. Second, summary financial statements, do they adequately disclose the applied criteria? Right? So just as in financial statements, accounting policies are given, in summary financial statements, the applied criteria should be given. Right? So point number one, adequately disclose their summarized nature. Very good. Summary financial statements, do they adequately disclose the applied criteria? Third one, whether in the summary financial statements, the management has disclosed from whom or where the audited financial statements are available. So check in summary, have they written where are audited available? And saying here in summary, they have written that they are available on the website of the company. You go on this link and they are available. And so is it written over here that they are available on the link? Yes. So has it been given from where audited are available? Yes. Then what happened? You click on that link. Tuck. And then you think that, oh, when I click on this link, the audited financial statement should come. But what comes? Error 404. Link not found. So though they say they are available there, you actually go there and check, are they really available where they are said to be made available, right? So audited financial statements, are they really available where they are said to be made available? So here, has management disclosed in summary where they are available? And now point number four, you actually go to that location, that particular link or website or annual report, and check whether they are really available where they are said to be made available. Okay, right, then coming to point number five. Now what you do, you compare these summary financial statements with the information in the audited financial statements, right? You compare. है ना कि ये समरी में यहाँ लिखा है प्रॉपर्टी प्लांट इक्विपमेंट 10,000 crore. यू चेक इन ऑडिटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स आल्सो प्रॉपर्टी प्लांट इक्विपमेंट 10,000 crore. सो यू कंपेयर द समरी फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स विद द ऑडिटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. देन पॉइंट नंबर सिक्स, चेक वेदर समरी फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स हैव बीन प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द मैनेजमेंट इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द अप्लाइड क्राइटेरिया. So in applied criteria, they have given that we will mention the breakup of our inventory, raw material, work in progress, finished goods. But you see summary, they have not given the breakup. Raw material, work in progress, finished goods, not given. They've only given inventory 4,000 crore. So then it is what is given in the criteria that has not been followed. Okay, so whether summary has been prepared in accordance with applied criteria, and point number seven is that whether summary financial statements are they at an appropriate level of aggregation. Okay, guys, summary in the process of doing summary, somewhere has over summary happened. You say, my God, you are having these contingent liabilities, so you should give the breakup of these contingent liability. No, but you're saying, no, it is summary. No, so one big figure you gave of contingent liability. It says, no, in the process of summary, over summary has happened. So check, are they at an appropriate level of the aggregation? Right, so these are the procedures the CA needs to perform when he has to form an opinion for summary. Point number one, summary financial statements, do they disclose their summarized nature? Okay, then tick. Summary financial statements, do they adequately disclose the applied criteria? Okay. Summary financial statements, has management disclosed from whom or where audited are available? Tick. Then are they really available where they are said to be made available? Tick. Then compare the summary financial statements with the audited financial statements. Then check whether summary is prepared as per the applied criteria, and check whether summary is at an appropriate level of aggregation. Right? So no surprise if I see a question on this one coming in your exam. So writing practice, vitamin W, you have to do the writing practice for this particular question. लिख के निकालो तीन बार, है ना, राइट इट डाउन. Right, certainly a question expected to see in your exams in this one. It's just a matter of time, whether it comes in your attempt or next attempt or, you know, spend time. Only time is uncertain, but the question will come, that is certain. You understand, everyone? Procedures, is it going in your head? Are you able to follow? You understand, no? You're able to see, if you visualize, if you understand, even though if you want to, you cannot forget. You understand, no? Some friend of yours tells you something 10 years back. You remember it till today. And as you become a chartered accountant, 20 years later also you remember, Aarti ma'am had taught that summary financial statements. 20 years later, forget. But at least right now for the next 6 months or 12 months, you remember it. Okay, right. And then it says, CA, you have to form an opinion, right? So forming an opinion, you have to check whether summary has been prepared in accordance with the applied criteria. And then for fair presentation framework, you say fair summary. And for the right compliance framework, you say consistent. Okay, now, yes, listen to me. If the auditor's report on the audited financial statements is having a qualified opinion, or it has an emphasis of matter or other matter, it says, now auditor, when you have to give a report on these summary financial statements, one, you will state that the audit report on audited contains a qualified emphasis or other matter. Second, you copy paste that particular paragraph. And third, you consider the effect thereof on the summary financial statements. Right? Effect thereof on the summary financial statements. Okay, you know, entire financial statements, your audited financial statements, you're saying true and fair except for inventory. है ना, एग्जाम्पल ट्रू एंड फेयर एक्सेप्ट फॉर इन्वेंट्री. सो नाउ फॉर समरी ऑल्सो वॉट यू विल से, इट इज अ फेयर समरी एक्सेप्ट फॉर इन्वेंट्री, है ना, फेयर समरी एक्सेप्ट फॉर इन्वेंट्री द इफेक्ट देयर ऑफ ऑन द समरी फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स इफ द ऑडिटर्स रिपोर्ट ऑन द ऑडिटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स इज क्वालिफाइड और इट इज एम्फेसिस और अदर मैटर स्टेट दैट द रिपोर्ट कंटेन्स दिस द ऑडिटेड रिपोर्ट देन कॉपी पेस्ट दोस पैराग्राफ एंड थर्ड गिव द इफेक्ट देयर ऑफ. However, if the auditor's opinion on the audited financial statements is adverse or disclaimer, है ना, पूरे financial statements पे auditor's report is adverse or disclaimer. Point number one, same. State that the audit report on the auditor contains a adverse or disclaimer. Second, same. Copy paste the paragraph. The basis for adverse and disclaimer or disclaimer. And third, because the auditor's opinion on the audited financial statement is adverse or disclaimer, you will say that it is inappropriate to express an opinion on the summary financial statements. It is inappropriate to express an opinion on the summary financial statements. It would not be right to express an opinion on summary. Why? Because audited financial statements, I'm saying not true and fair. And now summary financial statements, can I say, is it a fair summary of financial statements which are not true and fair? People will start pulling out their hair. What is wrong with you? Full financial statements, you're saying not true and fair. And you're saying the summary is a fair summary of financial statements which are not true and fair. Not possible. Full financial statements, you are saying we are not in a position, we do not express an opinion. Summary financial statements, you are saying it's a fair summary. Does it make sense? No, it does not make sense, right? So that is why it says it would be inappropriate to express an opinion on the summary financial statements. Okay, and one last point over there. Okay, auditor, when you are issuing an audit report on the summary financial statements, you will have title, address the opinion in which you will have the introductory paragraph. Normally 700 introductory paragraph has STAND. Remember we discussed yesterday, we have audited ta 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 ta. For disclaimer we write we were engaged to audit ta 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 ta. Now here in the introductory paragraph for summary, one, we identify summary financial statements, we identify audited financial statements, we identify auditor's report on the audited financial statement. Third, we mention that we do not consider the effect of events after the date of the audit report on the audited financial statements. Okay, say audited financial statements, date of report is 25th April. Summary ka report is being given on 25th of May. Will auditor consider subsequent events up to 25th April or up to 25th May? Obviously up to 25th April, because we are not doing audit again. We are just checking the summary of the audited. So it does not reflect the effect of the event after the date of the audit report on the audited financial statements. And summary financial statements do not contain all the details which are there in the audited financial statements. And therefore, kya mast likhte hai, reading summary financial statements is not a substitute for reading the audited financial statements. Reading summary is not a substitute for reading the audited financial statements. Why? Because summary does not contain all the detail. Right? So 5 points in introductory paragraph. Identify summary financial statements, audited financial statements, auditor's report on audited financial statement, subsequent events not covered, and summary does not contain all the details which are there in audited, and that is why reading summary is not a substitute for reading the audited financial statements. Clear everyone? Yes, clear everyone? You follow? 800, 805 and 810. Right, so let's take a break. After the break, do say probably the SRE 2400 and 2410 and then move on to our discussion of the professional ethics and the liabilities of the auditor. Right, so time for us to take a break. Okay.